Hi everyone, it's Dot, and tonight we're making a low-carb comfort food that is awesome during the holidays if you have any leftover chicken or turkey. We're making a chicken pot pie. Now, before we start putting together our pot pie, we gotta first work on the dough for the crust. You're gonna wanna use a double boiler for this, over medium heat. You can use a pot and a metal bowl if you have to, but it's so much easier with the real double boiler. Add your shredded mozzarella. For baking purposes, low moisture, low fat mozzarella seems to turn out the best. Now add your cream cheese, which is best added at room temperature. Stir occasionally throughout the process. If it's stringy like this, it isn't ready. You'll know it's ready when it smooths out like putty and is easy to work. Before it loses its heat, add it to your mixing bowl. Quickly add half of your flour, then your eggs. Mix what you have for about 30 seconds. Then add the rest of your flour. Add your salt and any seasonings you'd like to add as well. Then start mixing. And mixing. When it looks pretty good, pull a little bit out. Is it sticky? Too wet? If it is, add another tablespoon of flour. Then mix some more. When it isn't sticky anymore and it's evenly mixed, pull out a sheet of cellophane. Shape it evenly. Then wrap it up. Leave no air bubbles. Chill your dough in your refrigerator for at least 30 minutes before rolling it out. So now I get to work on my chicken. I decided to use dark meat. I'm using basically chicken thighs, skinless, boneless. I'm just cutting them up. I cut them all up into 1-inch pieces, not a big deal. And I'm using, you know, just about 6 or 7 thighs here. So I'm gonna add in just some olive oil. I'm using kosher salt here, and then some black pepper for my seasoning. And then I'm just gonna toss them. I wanna make sure all the chicken gets coated with the oil as well as the seasoning. Next up, I'm just gonna put it on a nonstick pan, all the chicken. And what I wanna do is when I put it on the pan, I wanna make sure I break it up. I don't want them overlapping too much. I wanna try to keep it as flat as possible. Single layers, basically. The chicken's gonna go in at 350 for about 20-25 minutes. I've already heated up coconut oil in my Dutch oven. I'm gonna add my onion and saute these for a few minutes. I'm just looking to soften these up, and they'll be done when they're translucent. I'm going to carefully add in my broth to this because the oil is very, very hot, so it's definitely going to... Here we go. It didn't sizzle all over me. That's awesome. So I have my broth in here right now. I'm using carrots, French green beans I diced up, and I'm using celery as well. Now, if you're looking at the carb count here, the carrots of all of these are the biggest carb count, but I'm just using one carrot, and that's sort of traditional for a pot pie. I decided not to use peas simply because that was a little bit too high in carb for me. So now what I'm gonna do, I wanna bring this to a boil, and then I'm gonna bring the heat down to a simmer once it boils, and I'm just gonna cook my vegetables to soften them for about 15-20 minutes. All right, we seasoned it, but the sound was off. So let me tell you what I did. I add 2 pinches of sea salt, and when it cools down, I'll taste it, and if I need to add more, I will. Black pepper and some dried parsley. My vegetables cooked a little bit faster. I set my timer for 20 minutes. It finished up in about 15. Perfect. They're all nice and soft, and I'm going to keep letting them simmer. I'm going to go ahead and add the chicken. I'm adding in my heavy cream. You can also use heavy whipping cream if you prefer. And for some people, I know that's the only thing you have available in your area. And I'm gonna keep continuing to simmer because I want this reduced down. The cream's not gonna evaporate. The broth will, which is what I want. So what I'm gonna do, I'm still reducing it down, but I'm gonna add a little bit of the gar gum in here. And gar gum is a thickener for low carbers. Now, you can't just add it straight to the pot. I've got a little bit of olive oil in here, and I'm adding just a quarter teaspoon because a little can go a long way, but you got to mix it with the fat. Otherwise, it starts getting really clumpy, and you're constantly stirring your dish trying to get all the clumps out. And I may add another one. You want to add this a little bit at a time because it can leave a thick film, which isn't very pleasant. So I'm going to let it reduce down a little bit more, as well as let the gar gum do its job. All right, less than 5 minutes later, everything just sort of aligned. It's nice and thick. The broth, enough of it evaporated out. We are ready to start putting this puppy together. And I want to get all the sauce in that I can get. Stir it up in here too, because you also want to make sure your carrots, because you're only using one carrot, you want to make sure they get well distributed, your chicken gets well distributed, but you want sort of an even setting here. Got my dough here. I put it on parchment paper, and I'm going to put it a piece of parchment paper on top of it and use my rolling pin to start rolling it. And what you want is just short strokes all the way around. All right, I have a round here, obviously, and a square here. But what I'm gonna do is just flip this on top and cut it into shape. And I've done this with pies many times. And anything along the sides, I'm gonna tear off because I can use that for a different dish. Or if you want, you can fold it up. All right, this is gonna go in the oven for about 20 minutes at 350 degrees. Pot pie is out of the oven, it is done. The crust browned very nicely. Remember, this is the Fathead crust that I'm using. It smells delicious. I wish it looked a little prettier. I have to work on sort of like on dishes like this, how I put it in a little smoother. And let's see what happens here. It is definitely piping hot. Actually, I'm gonna loosen it up here. Oop. That actually looks really nice. It looks nice and thick, which is what I want. A little bit of the sauce in there. I'm gonna get a little bit of the crust with it. It is smoking hot, so I'm a little worried I'm going to burn myself, but we'll see. It's hot, but it tastes amazing. The crust really tastes like a pot pie crust. It's not as like when you make a pot pie, how stiff the crusts get or how almost crisp they get. It's not a phyllo dough, which is fine, but it still has a nice doughy or texture to it. And the pot pie itself, not overly watery, which is really good. It's nice. It has a nice thickness to the sauce. This definitely is a pot pie. It's a low carb pot pie, but it is a pot pie. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you give this a shot. Give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. Share with your friends. And until next time, I'll see ya.